You're not going to want to miss this episode of the AI Show. Do you have time series data? Want to predict the future? Well, then you're going to want to watch all about automated machine learning and a brand new model style for time series forecasting. Make sure you tune in. Hello and welcome to this episode of the AI Show. We're going to learn about time series forecasting. Did I get it right? Tell us who you are and what you do, my friend.
Hi, everyone. My name is Sabina Cartasio, and I work on automated machine learning as part of Azure machine learning. So what we want to focus on is forecasting.
Okay. So let's start with automated machine learning.
Sure.
Tell us what that is, just briefly, and then we'll get into what forecasting is.
Sure. So automated machine learning is essentially an easier way for you to do and have machine learning and AI solutions mm-hmm. without needing the domain expertise.
Got it.
So you don't need to be a professional data scientist to have models and use machine learning.
Fantastic. And so let's talk about time series forecasting. Yeah. What is that in a nutshell?
So time series forecasting is a way to predict future trends. We have two very common scenarios.
Okay.
So if we go ahead and switch here, we can see that our two common scenarios are demand and sales forecasting.
Okay.
So demand can be something like predicting how much energy a certain city is going to have, or sales can be just the revenue.
I see. So when I'm looking at time series and you're looking at like revenue or predicting future, you have to obviously have a series of things, right? So what capabilities exist for that?
Of course. So we have a bunch of capabilities, the first being our time series learners. So there are specific models that work really well with, like you're saying, those features, time, revenue. So those are REMA and profit. We also have DNN capabilities, which works really well for large data.
Mm-hmm.
And we have grouping, holiday detection. So we want to add a lot of context to your data to make sure you're getting the best predictions possible.
So are these like models that we can build using automated machine learning? This is what you mean by capabilities.
Yeah, so capabilities, essentially you'd come in with your data.
Mm-hmm.
Once we have your data, we're going to go ahead and recommend, kind of like Netflix, we're
mm-hmm.
going to recommend models to you,
mm-hmm.
different pipelines that you can go and use in production. So you don't have to worry about, oh, how do I tune a model? What are the best inputs?
We
will give that to you.
So this is different from automated machine learning that we had before because it's a different style of model. Did I get that right?
Yes. So it's two differences. The first is that we now support the time column.
Mm-hmm.
Before you can do regression, but you wouldn't get a forecast. You would just get a revenue. So let's say you're predicting revenue,
mm-hmm.
you would get a number. But you wouldn't see over a month how that's trending. So now time series forecasting would give you a forecast.
I see. Because when you're doing like regular regression, it uses the time column, but not... It doesn't understand that it's actually a sequence of things
that's
happening.
Exactly.
So when I want to do this, what am I required to have in my data?
Of course.
Okay.
So we can go ahead and look at that. So I have an example here. The
okay.
first is a day column, then a store, sales, and week of year.
Okay.
So this is just a small kind of sample to get us started. The first thing that we're going to need is a target column. This is true for any AutoML or machine learning experiment mm-hmm. in general. This is what we're trying to predict.
Got it.
So this is our sales. The next thing is a column representing a valid time series. So our time series is our day mm-hmm. column. And valid just means it has a consistent frequency. So if you're providing me daily data, it needs to be completely daily. You can't skip
days. I see. So what if you have... So because I'm looking at these columns,
sure.
and it feels like, do you just have the date if you're doing day series and the value you want to predict, or does it use some of the other features in there as well?
So this is a really great question. A lot of times users will come with external data, maybe census information. And what we try to do to match that and make sure you have enough context for like pattern mm-hmm. detection is we bring in open data sets.
I see.
So things like holidays. If you
I
have
see.
Daily data, we can bring that extra context. We're looking at bringing in weather, things like that to help you.
And the models will take that into account as well.
Of course.
And so if I already have, because I think there's two things that you're mentioning that are pretty cool. If I already have context-aware data with the time series, it will use that to predict. But then we can add things like open data sets that say, for example, you might sell a lot on Black Friday, for example,
yeah.
and you want to be able to give that as another feature. Is that
of
right?
Of course.
All right. Yeah. So I feel like we've talked about this. Can you show us a demo?
Yes, of course we can.
All right.
So we recently launched our Azure Machine Learning workspace. This is a dedicated data scientist, citizen data scientist workspace. It's different from the portal. And we're going to focus on the automated ML tab.
Okay.
So we can create an experiment completely with no code.
Okay, let's see this.
Yeah.
That feels really magical.
So we're going to go ahead and create an experiment. We can go ahead and name this a forecasting sample. We're going to select the compute. A compute is, you can create one from here too. It's just the VM we want to use.
Okay.
It will automatically find the blob storage connected to your resource group and subscription, so you don't have to worry about that.
Got it.
I have a data set here called Dominic's OJ. Okay. So this is just an orange juice data set with some sales and how much it's selling.
That's cool.
So the first thing that you're going to notice here is we get a preview of the data. You can choose what you want to include and uninclude or ignore. So we see here we have the week starting. This is our time series column.
I see.
Right? We have a store, a brand, and a quantity. So what we're going to do is we're going to select down here that this is a forecasting
and
test.
That's the new drop-down. Okay, cool.
Yes, before we didn't have forecasting. Right. The next is the target column. This is what we talked about, the thing we're trying to predict. So here we're trying to predict the quantity. How much orange juice did I sell?
Got it.
The next is the time column, which is our week starting. And finally, we can actually group by. So let's say that you wanted to know how much a store sells of a certain brand of orange juice. You're not interested in just overall sales, but you want specific details.
I see. So that way, you're not just building a model that you put the store, all the stores in, and it says, foo. Instead, you want to be able to have a context based upon a particular field, which in this case is store.
Exactly.
Got it.
So maybe we want to predict for store two how Dominic sold. So we can say we want to do it by store and by brand. And the next thing is a forecast horizon. So this is the only technical input, and I wouldn't even call it that. That's just how far out you want to predict. So if you provided me maybe 3 months of data, I'd probably predict the next day or two.
Okay.
It's usually very proportionate in that way.
And that's interesting because then, like when you're training it, I'm imagining that when the model's training, it needs to be able to split the data in a certain way to be able to see how well it does.
Yes,
got it.
Exactly.
Okay.
So we can go ahead and enter any, not any number, but a good number here. I'm going to suggest 40 because this is a rather large data set.
And 40 is 40 days, 40 hours?
So this is really cool in that it grabs the frequency from your data. That's why we require consistent frequency. It will say, if this is daily that you're passing in, we're going to follow that same pattern.
I see. And if it's an IoT device that's doing it by the minute, if you put 40, it's 40 minutes.
It's 40 minutes.
Cool.
Yeah, exactly. We do have advanced settings. We're not going to dwell on this too long, but I wanted to note that we do have the auto ARIMA. We also have profit. So these are really big in the time series space. We have other options that you have there as well.
Awesome.
So I already ran this ahead of time, as machine learning does take a while. So we're going to go ahead and head back. And right here.
So this is the same thing, but already pre-baked, and you can totally look at it. Okay.
Exactly.
Got it.
So we can go ahead here, and you can see the Spearman correlation was the metric that we specialized on. You can see that auto ARIMA and profit were used. So you get all of your different models here. What's really neat about this is if you are kind of new to machine learning, you can get the download the best model option and deploy the best model all with a click of a button.
So you don't really have to do any of the wrapping and then writing your own scoring file, et cetera. It's all in there.
Nothing.
So I'm looking at this graph, and it's interesting. Is each blue dot represent like each of the run that it did with a different model?
Yes,
okay.
Exactly.
Okay, and so how high it is on the Y scale is how well it did.
Exactly.
And so that orange line says for the first run we did, we were not very good, and then it jumped up.
Yes.
And then all of the other models are the ones that are, okay.
Yes.
That's awesome.
So.
And so when you click on download best model, what does it download?
So this is a pickle file.
Okay.
So if you're a data scientist background, most of the time you're not just happy with what we give you.
No.
You usually want to go ahead and configure it, tweak it, do analysis. So this gives you that flexibility to go and play with a model.
That's cool.
And we're also Onyx compatible, which means if you want to use this with PyTorch or another open source resource, you can go ahead and do that.
This is amazing. Where can people go to find out more about this?
So we do have our documentation. Mm-hmm. So that's the number one place I would recommend. We are the first automated ML MS Docs. We are the first thing that comes up when you search automated ML on both Google and Bing.
Fantastic. So if you bingle with Bing, it's good.
Google or Bing is
good. That's right. Awesome.
We're flexible. So you can find everything here. You can also find integrations that we have with many other products, such as ML.net, HDI Insights, and Power BI.
Fantastic. Well, this has been amazing. Thank you so much for spending some time with us.
Of course.
Thank you so much for watching. You've been learning all about how to use automated machine learning to do time series forecasting. Thank you so much. We'll see you next time. Take care.